Hey, what's up? I'm KBHD here. So I had a thought recently, and I think I'm going to be doing more of these, you know, general videos on tech thoughts that I have. Let me know if you'd be into that. But remember Ultrabooks? They really had a mini era. Like, that was when we started getting many of these purposely really thin and light laptops. It was right around 2012 to 2013 as the tech was finally getting good enough to allow that. You probably remember these. But what you might not remember is that Ultrabooks was a term invented by Intel to sort of categorize and market and sell these thin and light laptops. And made a lot of sense. I think this might be one of the most successful, if not the most successful, tech marketing terms of all time. And it was at a time where you kind of had these different categories of laptops. There were the thin and light ones, and then there were the rest of the bigger, heavier ones. But if you've stayed up to date since then and watched enough Dave2D videos, or just if you had to make any sort of laptop buying decision in the last couple years, then you've probably noticed if it isn't a gaming laptop, then pretty much everything has turned into some sort of Ultrabook lately, in a good way. So this video is sponsored by Lenovo, so they wanted to toss in their latest X1 Nano to showcase this, but I'm gonna use this to demonstrate my point. So when Intel invented that Ultrabook term, they literally attached it to a couple key requirements, so only laptops that met these requirements could call themselves Ultrabooks. So some of these were a certain Intel ultra low voltage CPU, then a 20 millimeter maximum thickness, a 9 hour battery life, a 1080p screen, and it had to resume from sleep in 3 seconds or less, and then there was a minimum data transfer rate to encourage the use of SSDs instead of older, slower hard drives. So basically, if a laptop met all these requirements, then it was thin and portable and fast enough to be called an Ultrabook. And Ultrabooks were a pretty uniquely great experience, especially back then. Now, there were plenty of laptops coming out that didn't qualify, not just because they didn't use this specific Intel chip, but just because the tech wasn't as good back then to guarantee, like, making a laptop thin and light would be good. So there were also laptops that didn't even try to qualify, just the bigger ones. I remember my first laptop that I started this channel on, 17-inch desktop replacement, 6.7 pounds, I think it was 30 millimeters thick. Not a very long battery life, but that was a separate category. But today, in 2021, the tech has gotten so good that every normal laptop that comes out is pretty much thin and light and performant enough to more than qualify as an Ultrabook. Even though the term stopped being used as an advertising term years ago, I feel like I'm still subconsciously calling a bunch of laptops Ultrabooks now. So now there's just way more choice among laptops that you kind of just want to bring everywhere and work anywhere. And so now you need other things to differentiate yourself from the pack. So like I said, this is the Lenovo ThinkPad X1 Nano as an example. Pretty simple, clean design with a bunch of nice touches that I like. Starts around 1200 bucks, runs Windows 10 Pro, and it does pretty much everything you'd want from a thin and light laptop short of gaming, which you get a gaming laptop for. And like I said, the tech has just gotten way better. So this has a full-fledged 11th gen Intel Core i5 or i7 chip. This one's got an i5 and Iris graphics, 16 gigs of RAM, up to a terabyte of SSD, and it's all powering a 13-inch 2K display with pretty thin bezels and an actual anti-glare finish. Like, I've seen some others that say they've minimized reflections, but they don't really pull it off. This is nice. It's a nice matte screen that gets plenty bright. Now, you already know ThinkPads have had their own aesthetic. Pretty, like, simple, clean, not too flashy. Pretty serious, I would say. A little bit of a red and black theme going on, but mostly matte black. But yeah, nothing too flashy about this laptop at all, but that's what you'd expect for something targeted more towards a business customer. And they still have a bunch of their own little subtle things to stand out from the rest. So there's a little built-in physical webcam privacy cover. So anytime you're not using it, you have the peace of mind of just being able to shut it, just close the webcam and know for sure that it's not being used. Same as those pop-up cameras and phones. And the webcam itself, while it's a pretty not noteworthy 720p image, it also has optional hybrid infrared human presence detection. So if the laptop's been asleep or unused for a while, let's say you walk away from it for a minute, you walk back up to it, it'll wake up the screen and get ready to unlock right away, minimizing the time it takes you to do that yourself. The little eye in the ThinkPad logo glows on the back when it's on. They put a fingerprint reader next to the trackpad here for logging in. It's got the iconic ThinkPad track point in the middle, because you know there's still got to be people out there loving the alternate pointing device. And of the two USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports, one of them will do fast charging at 65 watts. Then they put four mics across the top of the laptop for the best possible voice isolation in video calls and things like that. There's a spill-proof keyboard deck with a pretty nice layout and backlighting to see it in the dark. And the whole thing, like I said, is this matte black finish. I'm not gonna say it's my favorite thing about this laptop, but I mean, it's clearly one of my favorite. It feels really nice to the touch. It's got a slight soft touch finish, and there's a version with carbon fiber on the outside lid as well. That's also pretty soft touch feeling, but that looks super hot. And Windows 10 Pro here is another nice touch. So it's got all the features of Windows 10 Home, but of course the Pro version has things like BitLocker device encryption on top of that. It's also got some extra enterprise features if you're using this for business, as plenty of ThinkPad buyers will be. But the whole point is, tech is getting better to the point where it's created a couple pretty sweet sayings. I've said cheap phones are getting good, good phones are getting cheap. Still mostly true. And now I feel like there's another one where it's like, if you don't need to game, you can get an Ultrabook. Like, everything is an Ultrabook. All the newest, best thin and light laptops are so good. Like, if you literally look back at the original Ultrabook guidelines, first of all, you needed an Intel ULV processor, but try a full power chip, the i5 or the i7 in here, either way, plenty of baseline power. Then it has to be thin and light, right? 20 millimeters tops. Well, this laptop happens to be 17 millimeters thin and weighs 1.99 pounds. I just want to pause on this for a sec. 1.99 pounds. I don't know if you realize how big of an advantage that might be this laptop's best feature. The MacBook Air is 2.8 pounds. I don't know if you realize the iPad Pro without the keyboard is 1.5 pounds, and then you add the keyboard and it's 3 pounds. So this is a type of like thing you just toss in your backpack and don't really even think too much about the weight. It's a featherweight. It's 1.99. If you do the touchscreen version, it's like 2.0, but that's good. And then what else? They also want quick waking up from sleep. Of course you've got it, literally with extra hardware to make it as convenient as possible. And then quick, snappy performance. And of course, there's an SSD in here. And again, it's not a gaming laptop, but for everyday tasks in working or school environments, of course, web browsing, notes, emails, that type of stuff, this thing is up to the task, and the taller screen I actually think suits it all perfectly. And it has more than a long enough battery life with 80% fast charging in an hour. Also, you can get this laptop with 5G built in, which is dope. And I was just thinking, if there was like a new refreshed Ultrabook spec for 2021, I think having cellular, at least as an option, should be an additional requirement, just because it's so useful to just, yeah, take it anywhere. It's lightweight, you've got internet wherever you go. So yeah, Ultrabook, no problem. The more I think about the way that marketing term was used, the more impressive it seems, because everything now is an Ultrabook. Everything that's not a gaming laptop can meet that baseline, and I almost feel like some gaming laptops might be able to also reach that baseline, but they're all so good because of the tech that they've got to find other ways to differentiate themselves to stand out from the pack. So with the X1 Nano, it's the webcam cover, it's the track point, it's the super, super light design, it's the matte black finish, and all that other stuff we talked about in this video. But that's pretty much it. Just wanted to share that thought and a showcase. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you very soon in the next video. Peace.